presentation of Carswell, The Final Countdown, is brought to you in part by Coors Light. Turn it loose tonight with a silver bullet. And your Dallas-Fort Worth Pepsi Bottling Group.
Well, tell me, Debbie, when did you and David buy that beautiful stereo?
We didn't buy it. We rented it at Action TV and Appliance Rental on a rent-to-own plan.
Well, you've got plenty of credit cards. Why didn't you just go to a department store?
We'd rather rent, because at Action we have no long-term obligation, services included. We can use our credit cards for other things, like paying that expensive repairman to fix the TV we bought from a department store.
Check the white pages for the nearest Action location.
One memorable night.
Thanks, Rob.
At the Silver Bullet.
Hey, you're Don Adams, right?
Yes. One Coors Light, please.
Would you believe? Two Coors Lights.
Great.
Ring, ring. Hello? It's for you, Don.
Terrific.
Ah, thanks. Mind if I join you?
Mind if I pour?
Not at all. Missed it by that much.
There's no slowing down with the Silver Bullet tonight.
You just did.
The summer romantics from Target. Blouses, sweaters, and knit tops, just $9.99 each. And flouncy skirts with petticoats, just $12.99 each. Heroism isn't dead. It just looks different these days. Romance, strictly 80s style.
Nice going, Mustang. Have one on me.
Roger, Den Mother.
Great. Trouble with your refreshment system?
Negative.
Diet Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
This Diet Pepsi commercial was inspired by the hit movie Top Gun, now available on video cassette.
Just Brakes stock. And Just Brakes will replace all four front disc pads on most vehicles for just $28.88 parts and labor and warranty them for 50,000 miles. Just Brakes, just because we care.
Rodney D. Young presents insurance expert auto liability and reasons to buy from RDY. Reason 256, no down payment.
It's true. When you call Rodney D. Young for your auto insurance needs, there's no big down payment. All you pay for is your first month's protection. That leaves you more spending money, and leaving you money is reason number one to buy from RDY.
Think young, Rodney D. Young.
Call 943-7303 today.
It all started back in 1940 when President Roosevelt had requested expansion of our defenses. Consolidated Volte Aircraft Corporation answered Fort Worth civic groups with a yes to build a plant for manufacturing B-24 bombers. Consolidated went on to become Convair, and today is General Dynamics. That was just the beginning of bombers in Fort Worth. It started as a dirt runway, then called the Tarrant County Army Airfield. Several other name changes were instituted until in 1948, a local hero was honored. Major Horace H. Carswell was a 1939 graduate of TCU and a B-24 pilot. On October 26, 1944, he flew his B-24 Liberator in a one-plane strike against a Japanese Navy convoy in the South China Sea. On his first bomb run, he completely surprised the force of 12 ships and proceeded to make a second run. Japanese guns severely damaged the plane, leaving him only two of four engines. He kept the plane aloft until reaching land. All bailed out when the third engine failed, except for Major Carswell, who stayed behind to save a crew member whose parachute had been severely damaged. He died when the B-24 struck a mountainside. For his action, he received the Medal of Honor, the Distinguished Flying Cross, the Air Medal, and the Purple Heart. Thus, Carswell Air Force Base was born. Colonel George P. Cole, Jr. is commander of the 7th Bombardment Wing based at Carswell Air Force Base here in Fort Worth.
We have approximately 27 B-52 H model bombers. We also have approximately 17 KC-135 tanker aircraft that refuel our bombers. In addition to that, we also have the various support agencies to support that mission. That's the supply people to bring the parts to the airplanes, the maintainers to maintain the airplanes. We also have a large hospital complex here at Carswell, one of the largest in the Air Force. We also have the fuels people. We have support system as far as the BX goes, the commissary to support all our people here at Carswell. Carswell is in fact the biggest bombing wing in SAC. And then I'm glad to say it's here in Fort Worth. The 7th Bomb Wing is a partner to Fort Worth. Not only is it a partner to Fort Worth, but it's also dedicated to the defense of our nation. We have a lot of programs that benefit not only Carswell folks, but also the Fort Worth, Worth complex. Although we're centrally located here in Fort Worth, you can be proud of your 7th Bomb Wing because our mission is global, and we go all over the world.
Explain to us what an alert commitment is.
On any given day, SAC has got about 30% of its total force on alert. Alert means that these airplanes and crews would be ready to launch at a moment's notice. They have to be ready 24 hours a day. It means that they can't go home at night, they can't take holidays off, they can't have leaves away from their airplanes. We rotate the crew force in order to make sure that we keep our 30% alert commitment. Normally, our crews are on alert for a week at a time. They live in an alert facility here at Carswell, and we have our airplanes pre-positioned for them. Every day, they go out and check their airplanes and run through the system to make sure that they're absolutely airworthy. Every night, they go back to the alert facility to go to bed. They have to be ready, as I said, 24 hours a day. Now, the alert commitment, I think, is shared by the families on base, because the families can't see their fathers at night, or their mothers in some cases, because we do have females that are in the tanker force. But the thing is, we have an alert visitation center where they can get together, and we encourage that. But I'd just like to point out that the alert commitment is not only from the crews, not only from Strategic Air Command, but from those families.
Well, we miss holidays, we miss birthdays, and this year we miss Thanksgiving. Well, we didn't miss it. We just had it on alert, but we had it with our crew. You know, there's a crew of six, and
you think of alert as being, I'm saying Thanksgiving. You think of Thanksgiving as being with your family. Mm-hmm. Well, we're on a crew with five other individuals. There's a total of six of us, so it worked out that we decided that we would have a Thanksgiving dinner at our visitation center, where we can, you know, all our families can come out and visit. And so we went out and we got us a turkey and all the things. Our wives didn't really have to cook. I think every wife had to bring one dish. And it turned out really to be one of our best.
It was a fun day. The boys had a great time, because there was a lot of other kids over there. It was fun.
We were in a family situation. You had, you know, not, you know, immediate family, but, you know, everybody had their family, their mother.
See, when they're on alert, like holidays, they really don't have simulators and jobs to do, so they do have some free time, so they can enjoy it with their family. So families can go out there.
Sometimes you have to spend your anniversary out at the alert facility, at the alert visitation center.
The ORI occurred, and they came on base, and at the same time, Debbie was
starting labor.
So
they put John on emergency leave. Yeah. They were really nice about it, because, you know, the ORI is like the, you know, that's the Super Bowl. That's the Super Bowl for us. So here I'm going, oh, is he not going to be there? But they were really understanding. They says, well, listen, we'll put you on alert. Put you on leave. And as soon as you have the baby, report back. And that's exactly what happened. And it was all right for me, you know, just as long as he was there. But
I spent all those hours in Lamaze class. I had to.
But, he was there, and the next day he flew the mission, and it went fine. You know, it wasn't a big deal to me that I didn't get to see him the next day. It was a big deal that he was there. And
an ORI, an operational readiness inspection, measures that unit's total combat capability, and the way it does that is that the unit will receive a low level to fly and a bomb run to bomb that they've never seen before. The unit will take that mission and will plan it from top to bottom, including the tanker support required to support the bombing mission. It's a total wing effort. It measures the supplier's capability to get the parts to the airplane. It measures how fast we can refuel our airplanes. It measures how well we can go out and bomb, how well our crews can refuel. It measures how many widgets we have in our stockpile. It is a total look at this bomb wing. There is a lot of stress, but it's not, I don't think it's overpowering, I guess is what I'd like to say. 19th Air Division is one of 12 intermediate headquarters in Strategic Air Command. I report to the 19th Air Division commander. He has, in addition to command at Carswell, he also has several other bases, including McConnell in Kansas, Altus Air Force Base, and Whiteman Air Force Base under his command, as well as Little Rock Air Force Base in Arkansas. When you talk about SAC, you're speaking primarily about two legs of what we call the three-legged triad, which is what we say deterrence is based on. SAC supports the manned bomber leg of the triad and the missile leg, with the Navy supporting this, the underwater submarine-launched ballistic missiles. Carswell's use isn't just limited to the Strategic Air Command. We daily train with elements from all the other services. We train in a conventional mission. We also train in exercises and deployments worldwide. Part of our tanker force is deployed in the European theater or the Pacific theater on a daily basis. And we train with those folks. We like to say that we're going to train the way we're going to fight. And yes, we have had to use our skills. And as recently as the Libyan raid, some of our tankers actually refueled the F-111s that struck Libya. From the time of detection, our crews would receive a message coming from SYNC-SAC, the Commander-in-Chief Strategic Air Command, through the command post. The command post would sound a klaxon or a siren, which my crews would respond to. The crews, no matter where they were at that time of day, in their beds, in the alert facility, in the base exchange, commissary, alert visitation center, would proceed directly to their aircraft and start engines to copy the message. The message directed them to launch, they would launch. They would launch and get airborne as fast as possible. They would proceed to a predetermined point. They would, at that time, react to whatever subsequent messages they would receive from the command post or the National Command Authority.
Are the pilots that are combat pilots here, frontline bomber pilots, are they paid any more to do this?
No, they're, contrary to popular belief, there is no alert pay. They receive their normal flying pay, just like their contemporaries do throughout the Air Force. Mm-hmm. But they're combat ready, Strategic Air Command crew members. That are as top-notch as any crews I've ever seen.
Major John Masotti and his wife, Debbie, are stationed here at Carswell. Major Masotti is a radar navigator on a B-52 bomber.
Tell us some of the restrictions that you have while you're on alert.
Okay, being on alert is when you're tied to an airplane that's right there at the end of the runway in a ready state. Now, the alert side of it is that we have to stay for 7 days, and we're in a facility. It's pretty much like a dorm would be. You have a bunch of guys that are out there with us. We have eating facilities there on base. We're allowed to move around the base. We have accesses to other places on the base, and that would be like to the gymnasium, the theater, mm-hmm. the O Club, the Officers Club, and numerous other facilities that carry a klaxon, which is a sounding system, which notifies the alert force that they have to respond to the airplane.
Debbie, do you think being a military wife has made your marriage stronger, or do you think it's made it weaker?
If I had to answer with one word, I'd say stronger. And I would say probably being a military family has, because for us to leave home and adventure out, it's sort of what we're doing, right? Because we're not tied to the little structure that we had at home, so we have to make it on our own. So I think it's made us stronger, because like when we move somewhere, it's just us for a while.
John, what's your opinion on that?
For us, it really worked out really well. I guess we got married in November, and in January we were on our way to California. So for us, I agree with Debbie. I think it really made us a lot closer and a lot stronger. You know, it made us depend on each other, and it's a little bit easier for me than it is for Debbie, because when I move, I go in and I meet people right away. You walk into a squadron or a job, and you meet people right away. Whereas for Debbie, you know, she depends on me to come home and talk to her and really be her best buddy until she starts meeting other people, you know, either in the neighborhood or the people that work with me.
I don't know. It makes us look forward to the times that we can be together.
John, tell us, what effects does being on alert have on your personal life?
Well, I guess the big thing, now that I have kids that are young, you miss a lot of their growing up. It's not as bad as if you're, you know, gone for a long period of time, but just last week we had a basketball game, and I think Johnny scored, you know, he had his highest points. You know, I think he was in double figures. And, of course, it was the game that I wasn't there. You know, all the other games that I went to, you know, he was
terrible.
Mediocre at best. But, you know, that one time that I'm not there, and you know, I guess that's the big part.
Debbie, also, tell us what effect this has on your life trying to raise these children when John is on alert.
I guess I cope with it by not thinking about it. I mean, you know, you just try not to think about it. Of course, like if there was a world situation, you're like right in front of the TV and you're real worried about that. But, you know, I think as far as I'm concerned, you know, just coping with the family and doing what I normally do and trying to do what he's supposed to do too.
John, do you think you're under a lot of stress while you're on alert?
We're constantly being evaluated. All right. But normally, you know, we go out on alert, and we have to study the mission that we're going to fly, or, you know, if we're tasked to fly, you know, we have to study that. So the first day is spent studying. The second day, we go back and do more studying, but in this process, we're taking tests. And for us to be notified of alert, it comes down in a message format. You know, we were talking earlier about you follow the daily situations, you know, or you're expecting. For my line of job, it's probably going to occur, and it's going to build up, hopefully. It's not going to all of a sudden break out. And we were sitting on alert, and at the time, it was back when the computer malfunctioned, and they thought we were under attack, so they sent the message to the aircrafts. Our horn, our klaxons went off, and we ran out to the airplane, and we decoded an actual message that was telling us to prepare for, you know, takeoff. And you know, we all asked the command post to say message again, repeat message, because nobody, you know, really thought what they were saying. And you know, the airplane got real quiet. We thought about we really didn't think. We, you know, the airplane got real quiet, and we just started wondering. He says, okay, who watched the news? Did something go wrong today? You know, who read the newspaper? You know, so everybody was quizzing everybody, and you know, the message didn't change, so we just wound up, you know, the airplane got really quiet. And, you know, the thing that entered my mind, I said, well, damn, I didn't get to talk to Debbie before I left. So that was about that I thought about.
I'm here with Larry Moynihan. Harv bragged that he could beat 7-Eleven's price on soft drinks. Were you successful at all, Marv?
No.
So what have we learned from this, Marvin?
Well, the day in and day out, it's virtually impossible to beat 7-Eleven's price on 2-liter bottles of soft drinks.
Yeah. 2-liter soft drinks, just $1.39 every day. 7-Eleven. Now even good prices come easy. Is your family watching at all, Marv?
Yes.
Yeah, that's good. They got to be real proud of you.
Your Dallas Metro Ford dealer continues 3.9% financing, or get up to $600 cash back on new Ford Escorts, world's best-selling car, and 3.9% or up to $600 cash back on Tempos. Plus, get Ford's new 6-year, 60,000-mile powertrain warranty on the best-built American cars. Special April Escort and Tempo allocations mean special prices. But hurry, 3.9% or cash back ends April 30th. See your Dallas Metro Ford dealer, the Ford Force.
One unforgettable Saturday at the Silver Bullet.
Excuse me, Bob, please.
He's over there.
Coors Light, Lou.
Congratulations, Bob. You finally got a job. We'd like for you and your spouse to please move out of the house. Good luck, love, Mom and Dad. Yeah.
Hey, she's not bad.
And he's not Bob.
There's no slowing down with the Silver Bullet tonight.
While some auto parts stores are asleep on the job, Chief has longer hours.
Good evening, Chief Auto Parts.
And now, Chief is having a spring sale with savings like Quaker State Motor Oil, just 77 cents a quart. Autolite Spark Plugs, 59 cents each after rebate. And Fram Air Filters, starting as low as $2.99 each. Call toll-free 24 hours for the Chief store that's open near you. Chief Auto Parts, we're ready to work. When you are.
Wednesday night at 8.
Our job is to be ready and able to strike back anywhere in the world if this country's ever attacked.
Jimmy Stewart.
I had to make a decision and I made it. I'm not getting out at all. I'm staying in the Air Force permanently.
June Allison.
They need a crew. Stand by for immediate bailout when you hear the long ring.
They are the Vigilant Ones, the Protectors. They are the Strategic Air Command. Wednesday night at 8.
The 301st TAC Fighter Wing, under General Irwin's command, is a F-4 fighter outfit in the United States Air Force Reserves. They are located here at Carswell with us, and as such, are one of our tenant organizations. They operate as a separate fighter wing under General Irwin, not under my command. And we support them with facilities and the various and sundry support ancillary functions that they would require. If you want to look at it as a sister unit, I think that would be a good way to look at it. Okay. We work together.
Brigadier General Ralph D. Irwin is commander of the 301st Tactical Fighter Wing Reserve Unit at Carswell Air Force Base. Brigadier General Irwin's Air Force career spans over 32 years. General Irwin is unique in that he is a flying general with more than 6,800 hours of flying time.
The 301st is just a fighter wing. It's just a fighter wing with reserve air crews, reserve personnel. It's a standby. It's a standby for the active duty.
Now, what do you mean by reserve personnel?
Well, okay, the active duty has a force at large, you might call it. There's a force ready for an immediate response. And once if the conflict becomes large enough and they have to have a reserve force to accommodate that type of a war or a fight, then that's where we come into play. We're a fighter organization, which you can see. We have the F-4 Phantoms. Primary mission is air-to-ground delivery of munitions to a target area. Also, because of the fact that it does have the radar capability and the missile capability, we train also for air-to-air engagements as well, or air defense.
Explain your relationship with the Air Force and in the National Defense.
Well, let me talk a minute about the Air Reserve Forces, which is ourselves and the National Guard, and we make up a third of the tactical Air Force. Now, if you're familiar with the tactical Air Force in the United States, which are all the fighter units throughout the base, throughout the country, we make up a third of their strength. And so we play a very large role in the overall mission of TAC.
How many days does an Air Force reservist, and in particular an Air Force reserve pilot, have to put in with your unit?
Probably 12 to 15 days. By the time he did his weekend training, his flying training, simulator training, and so on.
It takes a lot of time. You get a lot of rewards out of it, though. But you do have to adjust your off-duty time in order to be out here. That is true.
And I'm putting in about 20 days a month here with the reserves.
If the 301st is called to active duty, explain to us exactly what would happen.
Well, we would go ahead and initiate a recall, telephone recall of all the personnel. We have the procedures to do that. As they would arrive, we would have already set up a mobilization facility to bring the people in and place them on active duty. And once a person goes through that, then of course that takes care of his family and himself. Then we put him into the job. We would start our mobility proceedings which is packing up and preparing to move out and begin to get ready to deploy to wherever the requirement was.
That's just part of the commitment that we have to uphold. If they blow the whistle, like you say, then we have to go. We just tell our employers, and of course they're obligated to let us off. But it, of course, nobody wants a war or hopes for one, but we're ready to go if we need to.
I was on the ground in Lebanon, got shot at a couple times, so I've seen the war from a war from that type of deal. But as John said, that you know, this is what our training is. This is the commitment we made to the government or something, you know, as a reservist to back up the active duty if they need our help.
Now, if you were called to war, how would this mission change, or how would your responsibilities change?
Our responsibilities wouldn't change any different than any other active organization, with the exception of the amount of time that they would allow us, approximately 24 hours, to assemble all of the people from all of the communities, regardless of where they may be. Some of these folks come from Lubbock, some of them from even areas further than that. And so it takes a while for a person to close that organization, their business down, or to settle their affairs and then come in. And that's why we have approximately 24 hours more to get ready to go.
Now, we're standing in front of an F-4 here, and it has two crew members.
That's correct.
In the front seat. Tell us about who sits in the front seat, what his job is, and then tell us who sits in the back seat, and tell us what his job is.
Okay, the guy in the front seat is the aircraft commander. And he's the guy who flies and steers the airplane to make sure that the pointy end is pointed in the direction you want to go.
My job is to get the plane and all the weapons that the backseater's in charge of to where it's supposed to be and put the bombs on the target. If necessary, fulfill an air-to-air capability that if we get tapped on the way home, then mix it up.
The guy in the backseat is the weapons systems officer. He runs the radar. He handles the inertial systems. He does the navigating through the inertial programs and to make sure that you get at the point where you want to be.
I'm a WISO, which stands for Weapons System Officer. My job is to, for an air-to-air portion or whatever, I work the radar, get into an attack presentation of getting the missile in the best position it can for a kill. Helping the pilot with lookout doctrine. On the air-to-ground portion, I help him on his low level, make sure we're navigating correctly. Timing, if it's a precision timing deal, I'm up there working timing. Again, also checking six to see if no other aircrafts are gonna come in and try to kill us.
How is the rapport between the pilots and the weapon system operator?
Probably like you would expect to be between the linemen and the backfield people on a football team, you know, who does the most work. It's good. They kid each other a lot.
You know, all the guy up there is just a basic monkey. I just get my little stick and tell him when I want to go left and go right.
You wish.
Yeah, you know it's true. My banana, you know, not that. But no, it's a serious business, serious consequences if you screw up, but I think you blow off kind of the seriousness with the levity and everything, and it makes for a closer crew.
General, most of the members of your reserve unit have already fulfilled their military obligation. So why do they do it?
We find, interestingly enough, and I talk to those who come and those who leave, that most of them come just because they like doing it. They feel that it's something that they need to do. You're going to say that I'm blowing a whistle, but that's not true. That is the primary reason. It is not money. It's just simply a dedication to the mission. They have a skill. They recognize that, and they come out here and participate because of that.
They're just plain and simple. You can't fly fighters in civilian life. It kind of gets in your blood, and it's something you did for 5 years on active duty or longer, and I think mainly it's the flying.
You make a lot of friends, and it's the most fun you can have with your clothes on, I think.
Well, I'd be out here for free flying because I enjoy the flying so much.
I like flying.
guys going, Mustang? Have one on me.
Roger, Den Mother.
Great.
Trouble with your refreshment system?
A negative.
Diet Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
This Diet Pepsi commercial was inspired by the hit movie Top Gun, now available on video cassette.
Nick Nolte is lawman Jack Benteen.
Thinking about taking him on? Might be fun.
Someone's making trouble in his town.
Well, I've been here for 20 minutes and I'm already having a terrible day.
But his idea of a good time...
We'll have us a little fun, I promise.
...is giving them a hard time.
I hurt my knee.
Looks like you hurt your head.
You gonna take on all the Uzis by yourself there, sir?
How much help do you think I need?
Extreme Prejudice. Rated R.
Starts Friday at a theater near you.
Here's a fresh idea from Holly Farms and Dinah.
Has a chicken ever had a standing ovation? Never. Unless you sprinkle these fresh-cut peppers over your sauteed chicken, the freshest chicken possible. Holly Farms. They guarantee the taste of first-day freshness, and they have a special seal that keeps it that way. You toss your chickens, and voila! Oh, you haven't even tasted it yet.
Holly Farms guarantees the taste of first-day freshness.
Early one afternoon.
Where's Lou?
At the Silver Bullet.
Lou, Jackie, Jackie, comedian. You ever think of having live entertainment? Because this place is dead. Of course you did. I'm hysterical. Look at these reviews. Some of these places are still open. I'll pack them in, Lou.
No, no, no. Coors Light does that.
I don't know who this guy Light is.
No, Coors Light isn't a guy. It's a beer.
A bear. A bear. Terrific no. Animal acts. I can't get a break in this town.
Did you hear the one about the mouse?
Come on.
There's no slowing down with the Silver Bullet tonight.
Here's a letter from a Mr. Mike Biglin. Dear sir, you say that day in and day out, it's virtually impossible to beat 7-Eleven's price on a gallon of milk. I wouldn't believe that if I heard it from my own mother. Michael, here is your own mother.
Michael, believe Mr. Coleman, it's the truth.
Mm-hmm. Happy, Mike?
For a limited time, a gallon of 2% milk, just $1.79. 7-Eleven. Now even good prices come easy.
Where'd I go wrong?
Now, don't do that to yourself, Mom. Don't do that. I'll tell you why.
There are about 25 SAC bases in the United States. And they have a global mission. They range all over the world. There are also SAC units on 55 different installations throughout the world. So it truly is a global command. And in SAC, we have about 118,000 blue suit Air Force employees. We base deterrence on the fact, on the preposition that we can deter an attack through strength. So that our enemies know that if they should attack us, we'd still be strong enough to completely put them out of business. And right now, we're coming up to speed on our conventional capability. Mm-hmm. That means dropping iron bombs, where in the past we've kind of neglected that particular role. We're really, really working it hard now, because God willing, on any given day, we'll never have to do the nuclear. But we want to remain resolute and capable of carrying out that mission. The conventional role, the conventional mission, dropping iron bombs, could come about anywhere, any day. Captain Danny Pegram won, he and his crew won the Holloway Award as the best tanker crew in Strategic Air Command, and we are extremely proud of him and his crew for that award, because it reflects not only on Captain Danny Pegram and his crew, but all the men and women in the 7th Aerial Refueling Squadron and the 7th Bomb Wing as a whole.
Well, my primary job is to fly in support of missions that require refuelings. It takes a lot of gas sometimes to get from point A to point B.
Mm-hmm.
In order for us to accomplish our job in the Air Force, it takes an airplane that can refuel any airplane in the Air Force inventory, and also the Navy and the Marine inventory, to offload gas to them so that they can continue on with their mission, either in deployment or in a tactical scenario. As a crew commander or an aircraft commander, I have a navigator, a co-pilot, and a boom operator that works with me, and we make a crew of four.
Mm-hmm.
And I just am just a management type person for the crew.
Right? Do you fly with the same people all the time?
Right. We try and maintain what's called crew integrity, where we train together and we go and fly together. And we try to maintain that crew cohesion all the time. But because of one reason or another, we sometimes have to make crew changes.
But what happens if one of the crew members goes on vacation?
Well, we all go on vacation at the same time.
You do?
It's very difficult scheduling-wise, but we all go on vacation at the same time. We pull alert together and pretty much just do about everything together.
Why do you do it?
Because I love it. I feel very good about what I do. There's a lot of people that have come before me to support what our country stands for. And for me to have the opportunity to do this, I just feel very good about it.
What would be a typical work schedule for you?
Well, normally we have what we call a mission plan fly. What we'll do is we'll come in a day before we're going to fly or earlier on the day of our flight, and we'll do all the paperwork for the flight and decide where we're going to go, where we're going to refuel, and what all the speeds are for the refueling and the altitudes and where the location is. And we put all this together in a mission package, and we review the mission, and then we go either the day of the flight or after we do our mission planning on the day of the flight, we'll go down to weather, check the weather, and file our flight plan. Then we'll go out the aircraft, do our pre-flight for the aircraft, and then we'll launch and go accomplish our scheduled refueling.
Captain Brian Buck Rogers is an aircraft commander of a B-52 bomber at Carswell.
Well, in the airplane, I share the flying with the co-pilot, the physical hands-on flying of the airplane. I'm ultimately responsible for the aircraft, any decisions that we have to make. I work with all the guys in the crew and get the inputs of everyone and find out, assess what our situation is and determine if we have to make a change to our mission. But I'm ultimately responsible for accomplishing the mission. We can refuel at a rate of about 6,000 pounds a minute, which is about 1,000 gallons a minute. So to completely fill the airplane, we can take about 300,000 pounds and be the complete load. If we're going to go completely from empty, which wouldn't happen, you can figure out the numbers there. But, you know, typically in 20 minutes, you can put on over 100,000 pounds of fuel.
Describe for us, if you would, what would be a typical training mission?
Typically, we'll depart from here, and normally the first thing we do after we launch is air refueling. We'll rendezvous with the tanker. Tomorrow night, the tanker I have is from Carswell. Yesterday, I had one from Topeka, Kansas, from the Kansas Air National Guard. And now we practice refueling, typically about a half an hour to an hour, because the refueling is a very critical portion of our mission because of the worldwide nature of the B-52 and the long ranges you have. We just can't get the job done in a lot of cases without refueling. Then after refueling, we go on up to a low-level route, and the one we flew yesterday is an area we call the STRC. Or Strategic Training Range Complex, which is a package of routes that fly through Wyoming and Montana, North and South Dakota, and a little bit of Nebraska. And the low-level route we had yesterday runs about 2.5 to 3 hours long.
You say low-level, what altitude are you flying at?
Anywhere from 400 to 800 feet above the ground.
When we're out training, we try and simulate as closely as we can what we would actually do in a combat environment. So we, in essence, train as though we were going to the same way we would do things in a wartime environment.
How does this stress affect your family life?
My wife, believe it or not, has learned to do all these things when I'm not around.
Yeah.
And we've been married almost 12 years, and we've been in the Air Force almost 10 years. And she does a very good job of being an independent person. And we have 3 children, so that puts another additional burden on her, but she does a great job of it. It can either strengthen the marriage or can help to break one up. Because of the time that we're away and things like that, it's very difficult for people to keep a good relationship going, and it tasks you very much.
It's been fascinating for me to be around the crew members, find out what they go through in their everyday lives, what kind of stresses they face, and also to be around their families just at social functions and picnics and things like that, and to walk away from there and saying, I'm not sure how they do it, and I'm not sure how they deal with the stress day in and day out. But after being here about a year and a half and watching what they go through and the separation from the family for a week at a time at the alert facilities and things like that, I've come to understand that that the pilots themselves love to fly. And that's what seems to make them, give them the strength to go through it. And the families are very supportive and very understanding. And the more understanding and the more supportive the families are, then I've noticed the less stress that the members themselves, the pilots and family members have to go through.
You go on alert and the dishwasher stops or the dryer quits working, uh-huh. or the cat got sick, or, you know, when it happens when you're on the pad on alert and you get the phone call from home, hello, now this is your wife, your such and such just happened. And you're sitting there and you throw up your hands, well, there's only so much you can do.
America, because the Coors Light Silver Bullets are on the loose. Yeah, there's no slowing down with a Silver Bullet.
In the air, across the water, rolling out on the track. Here yeah. come the Silver Bullets, then they're leading the pack.
Rodney DeYoung presents insurance expert auto liability and reasons to buy from RDY. Reason 43, low monthly payments.
It's true. At Rodney DeYoung, you don't have to pay for 6 months or a year all at once. You pay for your auto insurance the way you use it. 1 month at a time. Low monthly payments leave you more spending money. And leaving you money is reason number one to buy from RDY.
Think young, Rodney DeYoung.
Call 943-7303 today.
Stop. Don't buy a used car till you see what's happening this weekend at Town East Ford. They've made a special purchase of 40 1986 LTDs, Topazes, Marquis, and Tempos. And you can take your choice for just $69.75. That's right, take your pick. Only $69.75 for just $169 a month. And all have automatic transmission, air conditioning, AM, FM, stereo, and much more. This incredible one-price sale definitely ends 9 p.m. Monday. And when they're gone, they're gone. Only at Town East Ford in Mesquite, the talk of the town.
Nice going, Mustang. Have one on me.
Roger, den mother.
Great.
Trouble with your refreshment system?
A negative.
Diet Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
This Diet Pepsi commercial was inspired by the hit movie Top Gun, now available on video cassette.
We employ about 5,500 military people here at Carswell. We also employ, in addition to that, about 1,800 civilians.
Now that is just the people that work active duty here, but you're going to have to support a lot of other people. How large is the support role here?
Interestingly enough, Carswell supports the second largest retired community in the United States. Second only to San Antonio region. And when you take into consideration all the dependents, all the retirees, we in fact support a complex of over 40,000 people here at Carswell. It's important to note that our retirees tend to stay in the Fort Worth area. Ever since I've been here, and I've retired unfortunately about 15 or 20 of our long-term people, every single one of them has stayed here in the Fort Worth area, which means to me that our people come here and they find roots in the Fort Worth area. They feel comfortable with the Fort Worth people, and they tend to retire here in Tarrant County.
The largest employer in Tarrant County, I believe, is General Dynamics, and so this facility would be second.
I think we give them a pretty close run for their money, but we do come up second. But the important point to remember is that when you stop to think of all the money that's involved that we plow back into the community, we're talking about $1 billion of impact that Carswell has on Tarrant County.
How many people, do you know how many people are in the Air Force Reserve Unit here?
About 1,000 we have in this particular, 1,100 in this particular organization. On the base, there are some 1,500 counting all of the additional hospital units and aerial port squadrons.
Do you know the economic impact, how much money you feed into the community?
No, I can't answer that. But I know that we have a large We have a little over a $9 million payroll, and I'm sure that's welcome in the community. And then, of course, the whatever buying power that we are able to work through the government, through local businesses.
Carswell has not only an economic impact on the city of Fort Worth. One thing I'd like to bring out is we also give to Fort Worth and to ourselves through the combined federal campaign. Over $250,000 was raised last year by Carswell. And the important thing to remember is that 98% of that money stays here in Tarrant County. And so I think everyone would agree that Carswell is not only a good partner in the Fort Worth complex, but we're paying our way.
Nice going, Mustang. Have one on me.
Roger, Den Mother.
Great.
Trouble with your refreshment system?
Negative.
The choice of a new generation.
This Diet Pepsi commercial was inspired by the hit movie Top Gun, now available on video cassette.
Now, for a limited time, wrap up 23 of our finest. Come laugh. Cry.
I guess this is just another lost cause, Mr. Payne.
Dream. Scream. Jump and shout again and again. Wrap up Hollywood Encore. 23 hit films, only $29.95 each. Only from RCA Columbia Pictures Home Video.
Just Brakes stock. And Just Brakes will replace all four front disc pads on most vehicles for just $28.88 parts and labor and warranty them for 50,000 miles. Just Brakes, just because we care.
Hello, I'm Dr. Talcott. For the last 8 years, I've brought you information on chiropractic. Today, I want you to know that chiropractic examinations and treatment are comfortable and even feel good to most patients. Soothing ultrasound for your muscle spasms, diathermy for circulation and forms of pain control are combined with spinal adjustments to mobilize and realign the spine. Adjustments are performed by general pressure or by an instrument that gently taps the vertebra. Take your first step towards spinal health. Call today.
I'm Rolando Blackman with the Dallas Mavericks, and if I were looking for an all-purpose vehicle, like the Jeep Cherokee, the first thing I think about is acceleration and ruggedness. But what I look for most of all is reliability. You can depend on the Jeep Cherokee, voted 4x4 of the year. You just can't beat a Jeep.
Today's Air Force team. Aim high. Air Force.
Why do you think they do it? Why do you think they're Air Force pilots and pilots in a strategic air command?
I think over the years, we've seen a lot of people that come into strategic air command and they don't understand what the command is all about. So they tend to come into the command with heel marks dug in. After they come into the Strategic Air Command, they realize that in a peacetime Air Force, the Strategic Air Command has a real mission, deterrence. They realize that that's a mission that has to be done by somebody. And they take on a sense of responsibility that they might not have realized that they had to have before. And so consequently, they stay with us. They stay with us a long, long time because they realize that there is a definite mission there in peacetime. And it's a heavy responsibility for the young person that comes into the Strategic Air Command. And you talk of stress. Yes, there's stress, but I don't think it's an overpowering type of a stress. But I would like to I'd like to think it's a higher awareness of a responsibility to their country, because Lord knows you can't buy patriotism, but we've got it here in the 7th Bomb Wing in spades.
But I think the Guard and Reserve program is the best deal this country's got going for it in terms of value, bang for the buck. we do a good job and we're ready to go anywhere and do that job anytime.
I would say there was a common background to him. I think it's simply dedication.
Just the mental thought of what I do and supporting the country and what we stand for here in America just kind of brings it all together for me, and it's very satisfying.
It is fun. It takes a lot of work, and I think our rewards are the flying, the experience we get flying.
I'd almost give my paycheck back for my flying with the government.
For me to fly in the reserve and guard unit here was a dream come true for me. I've always wanted to do it ever since I was a kid.
Tonight's presentation of Carswell, The Final Countdown, has been brought to you in part by Coors Light. Turn it loose tonight with a silver bullet and your Dallas-Fort Worth Pepsi Bottling Group. This is KTXA-TV, Channel 21, Fort Worth, Dallas.